Welcome you all. Today we'll discuss about the local area banks. These banks were set up for the rural financing or in order to mobilize the rural saving and thereby investment in local area bank itself. In this section, we're going to explain the structure of local banks, their objectives and their functioning. The local area bank was introduced in August 1996 and in that year's budget, there was a mentioning about the setting up of new local private banks within the jurisdiction of two or three districts. The objective of that announcement was that it would enable the mobilization of rural saving by the local institutions and make them available and make use of that saving for the investment in local area was the objective of the new scheme proposed in the budget. And they are expected to bridge the gap in the credit availability and strengthen the institutional credit framework in the rural and urban area. That is, the major objective was to bridge the gap in the credit availability and strengthen the institutional credit framework in rural and urban area. And following this, guidelines for setting up of local area bank in the private sector were announced by the Reserve Bank of India on 24th August 1996. That is, in accordance with the or following the guideline, following the budget announcement by the finance minister, RBI issued guidelines for the setting up of local area bank in the private sector, and it was announced on 24th August 1996. Over a period of about half a year, as many as 227 applications for the establishment of local area banks in the private sector was received by the RBI, and 214 applications were rejected. 10 local area bank got in principle approval for the establishment, and 3 applications are under examination. However, due to the inability of the promoters to fulfill the conditions stipulated in the in principle approval, 4 such approvals were withdrawn. 5 banks were licensed under the Section 22 of the Banking Regulation Act 1949. Of these, only 5 local area banks are functions. 1 application is still pending. Out of this, only 5 banks were licensed under the Section 22 of Banking Regulation Act 1949, and 4 banks got license and 1 application is still pending. And the major objective of the local area bank was that it was decided to allow the establishment of local area bank in the private sector, and these banks were expected to bridge the gap in the credit availability and enhance the institutional credit framework in the rural and semi-urban area and provide efficient and competitive financial intermediation services in the area of operation. These banks were expected to, the major objective would be to bridge the credit availability gap in the rural area and enhance the institutional credit framework in the rural and semi area. And this must be to provide efficient and competitive financial intermediation services in the rural and semi urban area. This was the major objective, that is, fill the credit gap. Second one, enhance the institutional credit framework in the rural and urban area. And third one, provide efficient and competitive financial intermediation services in the area of in the rural and urban area. Key features of local area banks are given in this section. Each local area bank is registered as a public limited company under the Companies Act 1956. That is, they are registered as a public limited company under the Companies Act 1956. However, they are licensed under the Banking Regulation Act 1999. That is, registered under as public limited company under the Companies Act 1956, but licensed under the Banking Regulation Act 1949. The local area banks are the only type of non-scheduled banks in India. We know there are 2 categories of banks in India, scheduled and non-scheduled. These local area banks comes under the non-scheduled category. However, they are eligible to be included in the Scheduled Act of RBI Act 1934, subject to the eligibility criteria of RBI. If they satisfy or fulfill the eligibility criteria for scheduled banks, they can convert or they can transfer to that category. Local area banks have a jurisdiction over a maximum of 3 districts, and their basic function is to mobilize funds in the rural and semi area. These local area banks are established in accordance with the objectives of mobilizing the resources from the rural and semi urban areas. Some other features of the local area banks are, and we have seen that, are registered as a public limited company and under the Companies Act 1956, then licensed as a banking under Banking Regulation Act 1949. They have now function as non-scheduled bank, but they can convert into the scheduled category also if certain criteria are fulfilled. Some other criteria are, the minimum startup capital of local area banks were fixed at rupees 5 crores and promoters were asked to bring entire share capital upfront, and the promoters need to bring the full share capital. The promoters could be individual firms or society. There will be promoters, and that promoter can be individual firm or society. The family of individual promoters was not allowed to keep more than 40% of equity capital. That is, family of individual promoters they were allowed to keep up to 40% of the equity of the capital. NRI promoters could not exceed more than 20% of the total number of promoters. That is, there is a limit for the promoters from the part of the NRI also. Local area banks are subject to prudential norms, accounting policies, and other policies as stipulated by the RBI. Even though they are private sector bank, non-scheduled bank, they have to fulfill the, they are subject to prudential norms, accounting policies, and other policies as stipulated by the RBI. And such a bank has to maintain capital adequacy rate in accordance with the time 8% of the risk-weighted asset and comply with the norms of income regulation, asset classification, and provision since that is, they have to follow the CAR criterion also. Each local area bank is allowed to open branches in only one urban centers per district, and the rest of the branches were allowed to be opened in the rural and semi-urban centers subject to the requisite clearance in respect of the rural branches from the district consultative committee. These banks were allowed to open only one branch in the urban centers, and other branches should be in the rural and semi-urban area. That is, here the features are 5 crores, the startup capital, and it should be raised by the promoters itself. The promoters could be either individual firms or societies. The family of the individual promoters were allowed to keep only 40%. If there are if there is NRI promoters, then their share should be 20% of the total promoters. 20% of the total number of promoters, and the local area banks are subject to the prudential norms, accounting policies, etc. They have to keep the capital adequacy ratio, and the local area banks were allowed to open branches only in urban area, and the rest of the branches should be in rural or semi-urban area. The local area banks can do all normal banking business, but their major function was to finance agriculture and allied activities, small scale industries, agro industries, and trading and non-farm activities in the rural and semi-urban. They are allowed to do all the banking businesses, but their major function should be in accordance with the needs of the rural and semi-urban area. That is, the concentration should be on the financing of agriculture and allied activities, small scale industries, agro industries, trading and non-farm activities in the rural and semi-urban area. These banks had to give out 40% of credit to the priority, of which 10% is to be given to the weaker section of the society. And here, priority sector criterion was also given, and that is, they must give 40% of their lending to priority sector, and out of this 40%, 10% must be to the weaker sections of the society. The capital requirements of the banks are given. We have already seen that the minimum startup capital of local area banks was fixed at rupees 5 crore, and the promoters of these banks were required to bring the entire capital in, and it was also decided that a family among the promoter group could hold equity not exceeding 40% of the capital. The NRI contribution to the equity of the banks were not exceeded 40% of the paid up capital, and also 20% of the promoters. The entire initial capital subscribed by the promoters, including their friends, relative, associate, would carry a lock-in period of 3 years from the date of licensing of the bank. Further, the promoter's equity to the extent of 40% of the initial paid-up capital was to be locked in at least for 2 years beyond the aforesaid period of 3 years, subject to the review before expiry of 5 years from the date of licensing of the bank. That is, these are about the capital requirements and the conditions of the paid up capital. That is, 5 crore is the share cap, the startup capital, and this can be contributed by any individual promoters or the for the corporates, including NRIs, and their shares are given in this area, in this section. And the promoters of the local area bank would be individual corporate entities or society. The number of NRI promoters was not to exceed 20%. Voting right, individual shareholders' voting rights were to be restricted to a ceiling of 10% of the total voting rights in terms of the Section 12(2) of the Banking Regulation Act 1940. That is, individual shareholder voting right were to be restricted to a ceiling. Individual shareholding right was 10%. Area of operation. That is, the area of operation was restricted to 3 nearby districts. The activities of the local area banks were to be focused on the local customers, predominantly in rural and semi-urban areas, as to bridge the credit gap. Scope of activity, that is, what is the scope? That also was already discussed. Scope of activity is that local area banks were required to finance agriculture and allied activity, SSI, agro industrial activity, trading activities, etc. And they have a priority sector criteria. They have to fulfill priority sector criteria. And criteria also, the priority sector lending must be at least 40% of the net bank credit, and the lending to the weaker section was to be at least 25% of the sector and 10% of the net credit. The bank would be registered as a public limited company, and it would be licensed under the Banking Regulation Act, and they are eligible to be included in the second schedule of the RBI Act. That is present, and now they are working as non-scheduled bank. Branch licensing, local area banks were allowed to open branches only in one urban areas or urban centers per district, and the rest of the branch should be in rural and semi-urban area. Scheduling of local area bank. Local area bank could be included in the second schedule of the Reserve Bank of Act 1930, subject to the fulfillment of the eligibility criteria laid down in Section 42(6) of the Act. Now the license was given as non-scheduled bank. Regulatory jurisdiction. Here the regulatory mechanism of the local area banks are given. Regulatory mechanism includes, or the regulatory jurisdiction includes, the regulatory responsibility of local area bank is vested with, or it is with, the Rural Planning and Credit Department of the RBI. That is, RPCD controls and regulate the local area banks. This RPCD is within the RBI. They issue RPCD, that is, Rural Planning and Credit Department issue license for these banks as per the provision of Section 22 of the Banking Regulation Act 1949, and grant permission for opening branches at new places of business as per the provision of the Section 23 of the Act. And that is, licensing, branch licensing, as well as the license, as well as the opening of the new branches, license for the opening of new branches will be issued by the Rural Planning and Credit Department. The financial health of the local area bank is monitored through off-site returns and other statement required to be submitted by this bank. The appointment of CEO and chairman of the local area bank requires clearance of the RBI as per the provisions of the Section 10B of the Banking Regulation Act 1949. That is, appointment of CEO, chairman, etc. requires the approval from the RBI. Remuneration of CEO also requires prior approval of the RBI. The composition of the board of this bank is to be in accordance with the provision of the Section 10A of the Banking Regulation Act 1949. That is, the board of governors or the board of this bank should be in accordance with the provision of the Section 10A of the Banking Regulation Act. And as the local area banks are commercial banks in the private sector, banking policies are applicable to the commercial banks are made applicable to the local area bank also, except where this pertain to the area of business which local bank area are not permitted to undertake. The present status of local area banks are given in this year. We have seen four banks got the license from the RBI. These four banks are Coastal Local Area Bank Limited, established on 27th November 1999 with an area of operation comprising three districts of Krishna, Guntur and West Godavari, and head office is at Vijayawada and it is in Andhra Pradesh. Second one is Capital Local Area Bank, established on 14th January 2000 with area of operation in three districts, Jalandhar, Kapurthala and Hoshiarpur, head office at Pagwara, Punjab. Third one is South Gujarat Local Area Bank, established on 3rd October 2000 with an area of operation comprising of Navsari, Surat and Bharuch, with headquarters at Navsari in Gujarat. And the fourth one is Krishna Bhima Samriddhi Local Area Bank Limited, established on 28th February 2001 with an area of operation comprising three districts of Mahbubnagar in Andhra Pradesh and Raichur and Gulbarga in the states of Karnataka, with its headquarters at Mahbubnagar in Andhra Pradesh. The license of Vinayaka Local Area Bank Limited, Sikar, established on 21st October, was cancelled by the Reserve Bank of India, Reserve Bank, on 16th January 2002, as major irregularities were not in its function. We have seen four banks got licenses, but four banks were applications of the five banks were accepted, but only four were established. The reason is that the RBI cancelled the license of the fifth bank, that is Vinayaka Local Area Bank Limited. Presently, only three banks are functioning now. They are Coastal Local Area Bank Limited, Krishna's Bhima Samruddhi and Subhadra Local Bank Limited. This about the functioning of the local area bank. We have seen when it started, what are the objectives, what are the features, then various details regarding the capital, promoters, voting right, area of operation, scope of activities, registration and the licensing, branch licensing, scheduling, etc. So it's explained. Then regulatory jurisdiction, what are the who controls and what are the sections to be followed, etc. Explain, also explain, and finally the present situation was analyzed. The present situation is analyzed, and five banks got licenses. One bank, a license of one bank was cancelled, and presently only three banks are functioning in India. This comes under the non-scheduled category, and they can transfer to the, or they can shift to the scheduled category if they meet the criteria.